Friday in Miami is over and the fastest car of the day was Max Verstappen in the Red Bull. Shocking, I know, but behind him it was far more interesting as it was not Sergio Perez in P2, but instead it was the two Ferraris as Carlos Sainz and Charles Leclerc were second and third respectively. And the data from practice tells us that this might not be a straightforward weekend for Red Bull as their rivals continue to slowly eat into the gap that Red Bull have. We're going to be talking about this and taking a look into the data from an interesting day of practice in Miami. If you enjoyed the video, please hit the like button and subscribe for more F1 content. Now let's get to the video. As I mentioned, the data from Miami is very interesting as it looks like things in F1 2023 is starting to heat up between the likes of Mercedes, Aston Martin, Ferrari and Red Bull, but I am going to be talking about that a little bit later on, so stick around for that. But right now we're going to be taking a quick look back at the teams that were maybe a little bit further down the field to see who is where when it comes to the midfield battle. As usual so far in F1 2023, there is no real backmarker, except maybe Logan Sargeant and Nick DeFree. But the cars are all capable of fighting higher up the field, and this weekend is no exception, as it looks like the times once again are incredibly close, and it will come down to which driver will nail their qualifying lap the best, and nail the setup to have the best possible chance in the race. The battle between Alpine and McLaren is once again the biggest talking point going into this race with the midfield battle, and it seems like McLaren and Lando Norris was able to go much faster than Alpine in the qualifying runs, as the lap time show us. So let's take a look into the telemetry data from the fastest lap between Esteban Ocon, Pierre Gasly and Lando Norris to see where it looks like McLaren, at least in Norris's hands, were faster. As you can see with the data provided by F1 Tempo, McLaren right now are faster than the Alpines on the exits of all corners. And what does this tell us? Well, it tells us that McLaren was able to get incredible traction on the exits of corners, and this gave them a bit of an advantage down the first half of the straights. However, once the cars were more than halfway down the straights, the drag of the McLaren started to hold them back as Alpine then were the faster car. This has been fairly typical all year long that McLaren is held back as the car goes down the straights, but since they incorporated their new floor and gained extra downforce, they now at least managed to claw back some performance on a straight. But it is down only to the first half. Overall though, the pace between the two teams looks to be very close, and if Alpine can get ahead of McLaren in the race, then it will be very difficult, as we've seen from the opening few races, for McLaren to overtake their main rivals, on track at least. There are also some other midfield teams getting involved in the mix again, as once again Alex Albon in the Williams, at least in qualifying trim, can get into the mix and fight Alpine and McLaren. Williams once again have a higher top speed than McLaren and Alpine over one lap, so they can interrupt these teams. When we take a look at the fastest lap between these three drivers, you can see just how close things are between Albon and the Alpines. Unfortunately for Williams though, when we look at the overall number of laps, we can see that the pace of the Williams is a little bit weaker than these cars that they are battling. In fact, what it shows us is that Alpine potentially have great race pace and better race pace than their rivals McLaren, meaning that while over one lap McLaren have the edge, Alpine may be a little bit better in race trim, which could make the race in the midfield very exciting. Between the rest of the midfield teams, it seems very clear that Haas are the next fastest team, and they are clear of the likes of AlphaTauri and Alfa Romeo. AlphaTauri, at least so far this weekend, have been really struggling, and it is a shame because it looked like things in Baku were starting to turn positive for the team, as they could have had a very good weekend there. But now that we've talked about the midfield teams, let's talk about what you have all been waiting for, and that is what is happening between the top four teams, Mercedes, Aston Martin, Ferrari, and Red Bull. Well, firstly, let's take a look at the fastest laps. Last year in FP2, the fastest lap time was a 129.938 by George Russell in the Mercedes. The wild thing is, that lap time by Russell last year would have been only good enough for P18 this year. This year's fastest lap in FP2 was a 127.93 by the Red Bull of Max Verstappen. But why is the track a massive 2 seconds faster than it was last year? Well, one of the reasons is the track surface is actually different this year. And it seems like, at least on the racing line, there is a lot more grip than there was last year. The other reason is, obviously, the cars have moved forward in terms of performance this year. However, it seems like in Miami there is one potential big issue, and that is when the cars are getting off the racing line. Whilst grip on there looks a lot faster, off of the racing line though, grip is much lower, and it means that drivers getting off of there to either overtake or just by mistake could find themselves losing a lot of lap time, or even worse, making a large mistake, such as what we saw from the Ferrari of Charles Leclerc. As I mentioned at the start of the video, Ferrari was second and third fastest, and with this in mind, let's take a look at the fastest lap between Leclerc, Sainz, and Perez, who was fourth, so that we can actually see where Sainz and Leclerc are faster than Perez. What does this data actually show us? Well, what it shows us is that Red Bull is, unsurprisingly, much faster in a straight line than their rivals. However, when it comes to corner exits and braking zones, the Ferrari duo are able to close a gap up to Red Bull and are much better on the brakes and corner exits. This could be interesting as this was similar to what we saw in Baku. However, it does not look like there are maybe enough twisty sections in Miami for Ferrari to fully utilize this advantage. When it comes to the longer runs as well, there are some question marks surrounding what Ferrari are capable of. Certainly, they are there or thereabouts with Red Bull over one lap, but I am questioning where they will be over a race distance, and also questioning where they will be over a race distance versus their rivals. For Aston Martin, their one-lap pace might be very alarming. Fernando Alonso was 0.7 seconds off of Max Verstappen, and also 0.3 seconds off of the two Ferrari cars, which in F1 terms is fairly substantial. This gap will give the likes of Ferrari and Red Bull some breathing room potentially in qualifying. For Aston though, they have an advantage over Ferrari on corner exits, which is interesting given Ferrari has the edge over Perez on corner exits, meaning that once again Aston Martin has brilliant downforce. You can see that when we compare Alonso to Leclerc with their fastest laps. Alonso makes up all the time to him on corner exits, and is not too far away in terms of top speed either, so Aston are getting there in terms of straight line performance. When it comes to the race trim, Aston are potentially looking very strong. To show that, let's take a look at the telemetry between the two Ferraris, George Russell and Fernando Alonso, and what does the data tell us? Well, what it tells us is that in the longer runs, Alonso is on the harder compound tyres, whereas Mercedes are on medium and Ferrari are on a mixture of soft and medium. Even though Alonso is on those harder tyres, he is faster than both Mercedes and Ferrari, who, like I just said, were on the mediums, and he has similar pace to Carlos Sainz on the soft tyres. This can give Aston Martin big confidence that in race trim, they will be faster than their rivals, and for Ferrari, they seem to be a little bit slower than both Aston Martin and Mercedes, which is why I am questioning their longer run pace, as it does not match their one lap pace. For Aston though, long run pace is great, short run pace is a little bit behind Ferrari, and Mercedes are in between Ferrari and Aston Martin when it comes to the longer pace running, at least right now. But in the shorter runs, it seems like Mercedes is just a little bit behind the Aston Martin. But what about the Red Bull team? Well, for them, qualifying is the only area where they are potentially a little bit on the weaker side. They are under some pressure from Ferrari once again over one lap, much like we saw in Baku, but it does not seem to be as prevalent this weekend. However, in race pace, once again, Red Bull are in a class of one, and we can see that when comparing the overall laps between Red Bull, Aston Martin, Ferrari, and Mercedes. And here, we can see Max Verstappen has a massive advantage, which will be very useful for them in the race. So, what have we learned from practice so far? McLaren and Alpine are very close. Alpine are slightly faster in race trim, but McLaren are potentially slightly faster in qualifying. Ferrari are once again very impressive over one lap, but Aston Martin are faster in race trim. Red Bull could be slightly vulnerable in qualifying to the Ferraris, but in race trim, they will just fly past the Ferrari cars. So with that in mind then, what is my top 5 for qualifying? In 5th place, it'll be Carlos Sainz. In 4th place, Fernando Alonso. 3rd place will be Perez. Leclerc will be in P2. And Max Verstappen will take pole position. But just remember, that is only for qualifying. The question is though, what are your thoughts and what do you think will happen in qualifying? Let me know down below. And as always, comment, leave a like, and subscribe for more F1 content. Thank you all so much for watching.